This is a quick review and demonstration of the VEVOR Mag Drill. And this is the supposed to be the 1500 watt version and 1300 newtons. I'll put a quick link up to the page. This one doesn't come with any bits, and because of that it's only $209. Gets shipped in this nicely kind of rugged cardboard box. It's actually got a piece of wood in the bottom. Arrived in with no trouble at all. So looking at the construction of it, there's the electromagnet down here, and then this body is, I'm kind of surprised, it's cast. I'm not sure if it's cast steel or cast aluminum, but it's cast parts, very heavy. I think it's cast iron. Then inside there's a brass rail that's anchored to that. And then the part that moves is an aluminum extrusion with some kind of a steel rack and pinion. And the aluminum engages with the brass rail. It's got a couple of, a bullseye level there, horizontal drilling level there. The action on it is a little stiff, but I'd rather it be stiff than loose. I mean, it's perfectly acceptable. It's basically got a master switch that's the magnet. So if it's off, I've got a piece of half inch strap there to attest on. And if it's on, you'll see it that the strap moves with it. And then you've got a speed control and the actual go button. So not exactly quiet. Comes with a chuck key, and I bought this little, it's like a key thing for retracting keys, and I put that on my things to keep the keys handy. I had to smash the end of that drill hole through it. So this part of the drill here is something called a Weldon 3/4 attachment, and the Weldon just has a fairly precise 3/4 OD on a bit with two flats, and those two flats line up with, so there's just two set screws. Now this this VEVOR Mag Drill comes with a chuck and a threaded to Weldon adapter. And the thing is that a nice Weldon bit like this, I think this is a 2-inch, so that's whatever 25.4 times 2 is, 50.8 millimeter. That's like more, 60, 70 bucks, something like that. It's a nice bit. This much cheesier bit here, this bit comes with center drills if you're trying to freehand it, or you can run it centerless. Anyway, this bit's like 15 bucks compared to almost 70 or something like this. I'll put some links into these. So I wanted the one with the three finger chuck so that I could try to use these cheesey bits. So what I'm gonna do is I'll drill one hole with the cheesey bit, move the saw, drill one hole with a nice bit, and then we can do some measurements. Like, this is supposedly a 50 millimeter bit. Let's see how big of a hole it actually cuts. The drill does come with a cooling reservoir. There's the cooling reservoir, and it just has a tube. So probably the cooling reservoir goes on these bits here, and it flows coolant down into here, which I believe comes out inside the chuck. I'm not sure. Certainly for this type of chuck, I believe it comes out in the inside of the tube. This type of chuck with this type of bit, it's not designed for coolant, so I'm just going to spray it with a little WD-40. So I'll set you up on the tripod and drill this board, and you can see what happens. One interesting thing about this is it's got some kind of a speed control on it. So when you turn it on, it'll seek to a speed. So the same thing happens when you engage with the workpiece. You'll hear it slow down a little bit, and then you'll hear it kick back up in speed. And I just have the speed set to 1. I don't know how fast it seems to cut okay. So the magnet's on, bonded to that, and we're going to turn it on here. If I wasn't using enough speed to generate enough torque, or things are getting too hot, what? I'll try a little more oil and see if it'll go. Okay, so that was just about to punch through when it stopped. So I don't know if I was using too much pressure, or maybe it caught a bit, or caught one of the teeth on there. So that's the plug that it punched out. So that measured at 51 plus a little bit millimeters. So that tells me, since this is a 50 millimeter bit, that there's about half a millimeter bobble on that with this setup between this, the Weldon connection and the bit, and or the chuck and the three jaw chuck and the bit. So someplace in this stack of crap we've got half a millimeter wobble. So the native, the much more expensive native bit in, it's a 2-inch bit, should be 50.8 millimeter. So we'll drill with that and see what the finished hole size is there. Magnets on, and turn the motor on. So it smokes some, smoking more about the WD-40 burning off than anything on top. So visibly, just looking at this, I could tell that this had a lot less run out than the other bit. I'll try to use the video editing software to put a time on that. I might have been pushing a little harder on that one. This plug, if you look at it, looks almost machined compared to the first plug, where you can see a lot more ridges on it, which would, I think, would be indicative of the lower cost bit and the more run out. So let's take a measurement of this one. So with the nice bit, I get 50.78. 2 inches is 50.8. So 1.999, I mean, that's as close to a 2-inch hole as you could get with, I mean, wow, that's, so the nice bit and this cheesy $200 VEVOR tool, I mean, I don't know. I'm super impressed by that. So, let's see. The other thing I was going to note is that this tool, this version of it, there's a version where the foot sticks out farther, and it's rated for smaller bits. This one's rated for 2 inches, but as you look, there's quite a bit of room in here. So, it looks like you could get away with just eyeballing about to the center of that bit. It's got about 2 inches from the center to here, so that means you could get away with probably like a 3.5-inch bit. I don't know if this thing had the torque to drive 3.5 inches. Overall, I'm super impressed with this tool. For said, if you don't buy the bits that come with it, it's $209 currently, and the cheesy bits. Let's see, here you can see this is the adapter that comes with the VEVOR tool. that goes from the Weldon shank to the threaded into there. And this bit here, say it's really cheap, about 15 bucks. This one is more like 70 bucks, makes a much nicer hole. You know, but if you welding a piece of pipe in there, this cheap bit might just be fine. And I'm kind of impressed that these bits made these long curls. That means that you've got a nice cut going on, in my book anyway. I'm no machinist. So check it out. I've got links down in the description. They're all associate links, so if you click on them, my wife gets a little bit of money. And but yeah, pretty nice saw, pretty nice drill. Thanks for watching.